Thank you for joining us today while we stretch and get a little stronger. Today is a really, really special program because we're going to do exercises for people with Parkinson's. So before we even begin, I want you to meet Mike.
Hi, glad to meet you. I was diagnosed with Parkinson's disease in 2009, but in looking back, I probably was developing these disease over a course of many years before that. What I noticed most prominently was a slowness in getting going and moving, because we like to take hikes, and it would take me 10 minutes to catch up with people to get my motor going, so to speak. I also had the same experience in playing tennis, and I was a little puzzled by that. Then I developed neuropathy on one leg, tingling and as if your foot is asleep, and it also ran up, that tingling ran up to my thigh throughout the leg. I wanted to continue my activities that I love, hiking. We've done quite a bit of hiking, my wife and I. Primarily day hikes, but in various locations in Connecticut and New England, and even out west. And the same goes for biking and playing tennis. I've given up tennis largely, but I do a bit of hiking, and I love it, and some biking on the rails, the trails. Exercising keeps me moving, and it's a great pleasure, and it's the best medicine going I've found so far. So I might add that my wife and I love to travel. We've been to Europe several times out west, and we look forward to doing more of that. I enjoy tutoring. I've tutored adults, dyslexic adults, in reading skills for a number of years, and enjoyed that. Well.
Okay, and Mike is a very, very strong exerciser. And before you begin this or any other exercise program, you're gonna wanna check with your doctor, and he'll tell you exercises you should or shouldn't do. You wanna wear loose, comfortable clothing so you can move around without any restrictions. You'll wanna drink water before and during our time together and a lot after our time together. And work at your own pace. If Mike and I are moving a little too fast for you, slow right down. If we're working a little too slowly for you and you can pick up the pace very, very safely, then go right ahead and do it. But listen to your body, because your body will tell you what to do. Also, you want to make sure that the chair you're sitting in is nice and solid without rockers or rollers. And you'll want to look around you, because Mike and I are going to be working both with a stick. So you could either have a tube of wrapping paper, or you could have a yardstick, or even a dowel, or a pool stick, or a broomstick. We're going to be working with that for stretching, and for our strength training, we're going to have bottles filled with water. So what you can do is just get any bottle and fill it with a little water, and then the stronger you get, the more water you can add. And of course, you can add food coloring to make it really exciting. So you'll want to have a stick and a bottle of water. That's what we're using for a weight, but you can have any weight that you have around the house. Also, you want to check the area around you, because we are going to be stretching a little, stepping out a little, so just make sure there's nothing in the area. We're going to reach up to the sky to get good flexibility, and so you want to make sure you don't knock into the chandelier. Also, it's really important to exercise consistently, because when you exercise consistently, it sends blood and oxygen, especially oxygen, up to the brain, and that's really, really important. You want to make sure you smile and do what you can do and eat well, because that would one of the things that keeps your body nice and strong. Now, sometimes falls are common later with Parkinson's, and sometimes we tend to hold our arms stiff with scuffing small steps. So we're going to do exercises that make our arms really long, and we're going to be doing heel, toe, and high knees. So that's why we're doing them. Also, we tend to lean forward when we stand or walk, bending at the hips with a rounded back. So that's one of the reasons we're going to do a hamstring stretch. And Mike is really good at all of these. Also, we're going to add facial exercises. We're going to do the vowels. But of course, if you're home alone, you can sing, you can read aloud, you can chew your food vigorously, or make faces in the mirror. I didn't tell you that one. Okay, we're going to practice breathing also. We're going to do diaphragmic breathing, and we're going to stretch, and when we do, we're going to try to go full range of motion. Okay, are you ready?
Ready to go.
Okay, we are ready to go. So, the reasons that we exercise is to keep our muscles strong. We also want to improve our flexibility and mobility, prevent joint stiffness, make sure we improve our balance, and our everyday activities are a lot easier to do. Mike, you've been exercising for a long time and really hard.
Well, it's benefiting me.
So that's good. And also, when we exercise again, we shoot the oxygen to our brain. Okay? All right, we're ready to go.
Thank you.
So what we're going to do is practice our breathing. So when we practice our breathing and get the breathing underway, then when we do our stretches and exercise, we can add breathing to it. And Mike is really good at this. So one way we can practice breathing is to put our fingertips right on our bellies. Let all the air out. Then when we take a breath in, our bellies pop out. And we breathe out. And Mike, you had a good description for this. When we breathe
on the inhale, one can say, as you breathe through your nose, smell the flowers. Smell the flowers. And breathing out through your mouth, pursed lips, blow out the candle.
So that's a great one. We breathe in, smelling the flowers, and our bellies come out. And then we breathe out, blowing out the candles, and our bellies go in. So that diaphragmic breathing is really, really important. Good. So now what we're going to do is we're going to do an exercise using the breath. And we're going to start with the head just by turning the head. So we're going to breathe in, look straight ahead, and as you breathe out, turn your head this way. Breathe in, look center, breathe out, and turn this way, keeping the neck nice and flexible. Breathe in, come center, breathe out, and turn the head looking this way. Breathe in, come center, please, and when you exhale, turn the other way. And slowly come back to center. So that's breathing with turning the neck. Now we're going to add the shoulders. We're going to breathe in and pull our shoulders up to our ears. Breathing in, pull the shoulders up. And breathe out and relax the shoulders. Ah, boy, you do better breathing than I do, Mike. Breathe in, shoulders up. Breathe out and relax the shoulders. Good work. Now, we're going to breathe in and try to pull our shoulders back. Breathe in and breathe out and roll the shoulders front. Great. Breathe in, shoulders back. Breathe out and roll the shoulders front. So we went from our neck to our shoulders. Now we're going to breathe in and lift our chest up. So we're going to breathe in, lift our chest up, and breathe out and relax the chest down. Good job. Breathe in, chest up. Great. Breathe out and relax the chest. Ah, that was great. So we've already done our belly breathing. So now what we're going to do is we're going to add just relaxing our hands down by our sides. We're going to breathe in, bringing our hands to our shoulders. And breathe out and reach. Good. Breathe in, hands come in. And breathe out. Great job. So now we did our arms, our shoulders. So now we're going to move our bodies forward a little as we breathe out and lean back a little as we breathe in. So you'll notice both Mike and I are at the edges of our chairs. That's going to give us a lot more range of motion behind us. So here we are sitting in our chairs, nice and tall. We breathe in and lean back. And breathe out and lean forward. Good. Breathe in. And breathe out. Good job. One more time. Breathe in. And breathe out. Excellent. Very, very good. That's great. Now we're going to do something called a trunk twist. So we take one hand and put it on the elbow of the opposite arm and the other hand. Sit nice and tall, breathe in, and as you breathe out, turn your body. Very, very nice. Breathe in, come center, and breathe out and turn. Good work. Breathe in, come center. Breathe out and turn. One more time. Breathe in, come center. Breathe out and turn. And then come center and relax. Could you feel that one a little bit?
I did.
Good. Okay. Now, we did a little turning. Now we're going to do something called the chest opener. We're going to start with one hand and then add two hands. So we're going to take this hand and see if we can reach behind our head and our elbow comes up. We breathe in and pull the elbow back. We breathe out and bring the elbow forward. Good. Breathe in, the elbow comes wide. That's it. And breathe out and bring the elbow forward. Good job. And then we relax that arm. Then we use the other arm. Now that was good, Mike, because didn't you have something with your shoulder?
I have a broken clavicle.
Right. So that was great with your range of motion.
Thank you.
Okay. Now we're going to take the other hand, reach behind our head the best we can. Good. Breathe in and pull the elbow back. Breathe out and bring the elbow forward. Good. Breathe in, pull the elbow back. Breathe out and elbow forward. And then relax the arm. Now, something we're going to do, you can put your hands behind your head if you want, but if that's hard, what Mike and I are going to do are going to just put our hands on our shoulders, okay? So we're going to put our hands on our shoulders. We're going to breathe in and pull our elbows back. And as we breathe out, we're going to bring our elbows forward. Good job. Breathe in, and our chest opens up as we draw our elbows back. Good. And breathe out, bringing the elbows forward. Good work. Let's do that one more time. Breathe in, open up that chest, pull those elbows back. Great. And exhale, bring the elbows forward, and then we relax the arms. That was a really good one.
Felt good.
Great. Okay. Now, we're going to breathe in one more time, and when we breathe out, we're going to add our hamstring stretch. So this is really important, remember, because we tend to lean forward when we stand or walk, and even when we do stand, we tend to bend at the hips, rounding the back. So this is why we want a nice stretched out hamstring, the muscle behind the top of the leg. So we're going to stretch one leg out, good, and we're going to place the hand on our thigh. We want to be nice and straight for this one, so we don't want to drop our heads, and we don't want to round the back. So we want to have ear over shoulder over hip, so we're nice and tall. We breathe in, and when we breathe out, we lean forward from the hips, but we try to keep the head and the chest high. Good. Breathe in. Come up nice and tall. Great job. And breathe out. Try to keep nice and tall. Good. One more time. Breathe in, keeping the head high and the chest high and the back flat. That's excellent. Breathe out and lean forward. Very, very nice. Then we come back to center and change legs. That was a good one, Mike.
Felt good.
Good. So now our other leg is extended, but the knee is not snapped out. So we have a little bitty bend in there because we don't want to hurt the back of the knee while we're trying to stretch out the muscle behind the top part of the leg. So we have our hand on our leg, and that supports the weight of our upper body so we don't strain the body. So we breathe in through the nose, sitting nice and tall. And we exhale, leaning forward from the hips, keeping our heads and chests up. Good, good. Breathe in, sitting nice and tall. And exhale. Good. Third and last time, breathe in nice and tall. And breathing out. Very, very nice. And slowly come back to center. That was good. Okay, now with our stretches, we're done with those. We're going to grab our weight. So you can grab any bottle. We start with a little bit of water, and then the stronger we get, the more and more water that we add. Mike has a much heavier weight than I do. Okay, we're gonna sit nice and tall, and we're gonna bring our weight. Our elbows are down under our shoulders. This is called a bicep curl. We're gonna bring the weight right under our chin. Good, and down to the legs. Good. So this is strengthening our muscles. We really use these biceps when we pick up things like the groceries. We're always picking up bags of groceries. Or if we have to take the trash out, Mike, we have to pick the trash bag up. There you go. Good. So we need these muscles to pick stuff up. These are our biceps, the muscles that are in front of the arm. And they go right between the elbow and the shoulder, right on the front of the arm. Good. So when we do this, the more and more we do this, the stronger we get. And then we would add more water to make our weight heavier. Okay, now we're going to hold it right here. Good. We're going to use this as we lean back, keeping the back nice and flat. We're going to push this forward when we lean back. So now we're working our stomachs. Good. And then we bring it right back to our chest. Good job. So now we've added the stomach with our biceps. Oh, I can feel that. Good job. Excellent. Excellent. So we're still doing a bicep curl, but now we've added the stomach muscles. I can feel that. Can you?
I can.
Good. One more time, please. And then we're going to do something that's a little unusual. Because we have our liquid here, we're going to bring the weight from side to side, and that's going to work our waist a little bit. So the liquid kind of pushes it to one side and pushes it to the other side. Good work. We're nice and tall. Can you feel that in the waist at all?
I do.
Good.
But it's still comfortable.
Good, good. And Mike is doing a real good job of monitoring his exercises, knowing when it's comfortable, and he knows when to stop and when to take a rest. So thank you for adding that, Mike. And now we're going to relax. Let's not only put that down, but let's grab some water because we want to stay well hydrated. So we're going to take our water and take a nice drink of water. We drink just as much water as we can. Good work. Now we're going to grab our stick and we're going to work full range of motion. And then we're going to add the breathing only if you want to. Now Mike has a dowel and I'm going to use a rolled up map. Okay? So we're just going to let it relax right on our thighs. or our knees. We're going to breathe in and just bring it up a little bit, like just chest high. Breathe in, and then we're going to breathe out and relax it down. Good. Breathe in and have it come just above your head a little bit. Good job. Breathe out and let it come down. Very, very nice. Now we're going to breathe in and let it come up a little higher if we can. Very nice. And exhale, letting it come down. Good work. Let's try to do that again. We want to go as high as we can. Breathe in. Stretch high, high, high. Good work. Exhale and bring those arms down. That was good. How do you feel?
Fine.
Good.
Thank you.
Now we're going to bring one end up and keep the other end by the knee. Breathe in, lifting one end up, and breathe out, bringing it down. Good. Breathe in, see if we can bring that arm up. Excellent, excellent. And we relax it down. Very nice. Breathe in and lift. Exhale, relax it down. Very, very nice. Breathe in and lift. Good work. Exhale and down. That's great. Now we're going to take our stick and we're going to put it right down between our feet. Our hands are right on the stick. We're going to breathe in nice and tall, head high, chest high. And as we exhale, we're going to lean forward. Feel that stretch. Good. Breathe in nice and tall. There you go. Breathe out and lean forward. Very, very nice. One more time, please. Breathe in, sit nice and tall. And as you breathe out, lean forward from the hinge on the hips, nice straight body. And you'll notice Mike is really getting a good stretch on those arms, too. And slowly come back. That's good. Very, very nice, Mike. Okay. Now, we're going to do some isometric strength training. We're going to hold on to our stick, and we're going to try to push our hands together. So we're going to try to push, 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 breathing out. Breathe in. And when we breathe out, try to pull your arms wide, 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 and relax. That was pretty doggone good. Okay, we're going to get a nice stretch. This time, only this hand is on top, and this hand is on our leg. We breathe in, and as we breathe out through pursed lips, stretch forward, forward. We want to go as far as we can because we're working on full range of motion. Good job. Then we push our hand into the thigh and slowly come up. Good job. Let's do it again. Breathe in, long, beautiful spine. Exhale and fold forward. Very nice. That's excellent. And slowly come back. Good work. Let's try the other hand. So we take this hand, put it on the stick, and the other hand on the thigh. And that supports our upper body so we don't strain our back as we're leaning forward. Nice big breath in through the nose. Breathe out through pursed lips. And get a good stretch. So this stretches our arms and the sides of our backs. Breathing in nice and tall. Good job. Breathe out. Good, 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 good. Excellent. And slowly come back to center. That was a really, really, really good stretch. That was excellent.
Feels good.
One of the things we also want to practice when we walk is to go heel toe. So we're going to push the heel down with the toe up and then push that toe down. Good. Lift the toe up and push the toe down. One more time. Lift that toe up and push that toe down. Great job. So we're going to pull this foot in and extend the other foot just a little bit. We're going to lift the toe up because that tightens the muscles on the front side of the shin. And push the toe down and that contracts the muscles on the back of the lower leg. Pull the toe up just like we were stepping heel toe. And push those toes down. Good job. One more time. Lift those toes up and push the toe down. That was great. One other thing that we do, and we can put these down if we'd like, is it's important to do your facial muscles. So we're going to incorporate that in breathing. We really want to work our facial muscles. So we're going to breathe in and take a big wide mouth. And as we exhale, we're going to go A. So we're going to go A-E-I-O-U. But when we come forward, we're going to lean forward, and that's going to squish all the air out of our tummies. So we breathe in, open the mouth, A. Breathe in. Now we're doing E. Big smile. E. Great. Breathe in. Now we're doing I. I. Good. Breathe in. O is next. O. Excellent. And you. You. Great job. Those were our vowels, and you did terrifically. So you're supposed to sing when you can, but if you don't feel like it, you can always do the vowels. So keeping your mouth nice and flexible is really important. You did a great job. We can even take our jaws and move them side to side, side to side, side to side, side to side. Excellent. Good job. And then we'll open our mouths as wide as they'll go and close them and purse the lips like we've just eaten a lemon. Good job. One more time. Open it as wide as you can go and then purse your lips like you've eaten a lemon. That was good. Mike and I really appreciate you joining us today. We're going to take a great big breath in and stretch up to the sky. Remember, if you reach for the moon and you don't make the moon, you're always likely to land on a star. Exhale. Psh. Great big breath in. Exhale. Shh. You did a great job. Thank you for joining us, and we'll see you real soon. Remember the importance of exercising consistently, eating well, and drinking that water. Let's have a toast, Mike. Cheers.
Keep moving.
Keep moving. All righty.
Funding for Simsbury Community Television is provided in part by contributions from viewers like you. Thank you.